HWC2017, if you take any selfies around these premises and you hashtag them HWC2017, then be your friend.
Rumble and moan. I feel like a dad whose son just figured out there's no Santa Claus. I know it hurts. I know you thought your wishes had a universe all to their own, but give it 20 years.
We'll be really close. Okay. So this is what I go through, and these numbers, speed defines your universe. So I think about speed as your ability to change your universe in so many different ways. Because the way you move dictates how people are going to interact with you, how you're going to interact with people, and how much stuff you can get out there, and how many people you'll be able to communicate that. And I kind of broke that idea up into four different ways.
Okay, so speed is like how fast you can execute these concepts, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
and I'm a huge physics lover, and so I think about speed in like its very literal way. You know, like when you're driving through a place, what is the difference in speed? It means that you're going over a greater amount of time, and then you're putting out.
So then it's like content per days.
The content is the space.
The number of pieces of content per whatever.
Yeah.
Getting it out
sort
there.
Of. Yeah, and this is all the different aspects. So I think of the first level, I'm trying to go as fast as possible, but I think of the first level as when, and not member, just think about that as an entrepreneur, because I didn't want to end up this that much. But for an entrepreneur, I think the first basic thing, when you're first starting, you should be investing about $20 a month into what you're doing. Just on that basic level, in different ways, you make your first, and this is a good way not to overinvest also. And because overinvestment is a burden that can slow you down. Because now you've overinvested. You have 600 of the pink bunnies because you thought the next rage was going to be pink bunnies, and you overthought yourself into a hole. And now you are a pink bunny center instead of being what you really were, which was an entrepreneur who thinks of products that people want to buy that are cute. So you can play it around a little bit more. So that $20 might be a really cheap prototype. Whatever it is, I think in this area you're doing a lot of just getting your, and this is for an immediate focus on entrepreneurship. There's different ways to go about it. And you can kind of take the ideas and put it into whatever kind of entrepreneur you're doing. This is a way to use media to boost your growth. Social media videos, everything like that. You should be spending about $20 a month in this first stage, and then you move into your main sources of equity at this point. That's what you're really focusing on. It's having a cool social media, having a nice blog, maybe you bought a little template, whatever. Don't spend too much. I don't think your first web chat should be your $3,500 website. It's not a good look. You know, you don't get, you know, the $500 haircut when you're going to an interview or something like that. You don't know. You couldn't do that every single time. And then your blog really nicely set up through YouTube, and then have a basic version of your website using Tumblr or something like that. How does this map to your experiences?
Yeah, I agree. You know, I definitely overinvested on my first website. It was like $200 investment. And I could have used Weebly or Wix and done it way cheaper. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 websites that I'm curating now, and that's not even the best looking on my websites. But it was my first one, and it was my first experience. I was really excited.
I think that's safe, because I think this is based off of a month. So you should have a $20 a month website. If your first big piece of brand media equity is a Squarespace site or a Weebly site, that's a good level of investment. Don't do anything else.
You don't have to go that route, but I was
Social media and blogging. Okay. No, that was really good. I was just
about not supporting someone, so I'm leaving on reposting, sharing with other people, doing, right? And I kind of get into it, someone who has a Facebook professional page, doesn't
I'm okay with people posting their like personal stuff. If you want to go eat ice cream, this gives people context about your life and stuff like that. But it's good to have a Facebook page just as, because if I'm tagging someone, I don't really want to tag their personal page. And then on my personal page, I have a bunch of things. So people try to tag me or whatever they're doing. Like, oh, I'm selling Spurs jerseys. I'm like, I'm not involved in your Spurs jersey sales scheme. Don't tag me. So it's hard to tag my personal page. And it's just different. It's good to have a personal page. So that was good. Now I'm just going to move through kind of these next things really fast. I just want to touch on this level, on all of them. And if you're more interested, I have these just up on projectforward.tv. And you can just download them and look at them all together. But I want to run through some of these other ones. So I think you consider yourself a creator when whatever it is that you're investing the $20 a month in, these are just rough values, it starts making you about $200 a month. I think that's a really good place to be. And then at that level, you're going to be doing, how you're going to be doing that, you're going to be creating events, whether there's sales events or a big show, something like that, host a workshop, create a project of some sort, and so on. Something that you're, that's engaging your ability to be an entrepreneur in some sort of way. And then just to run through it, then I think it's, you're at the point where you can start investing like $400 a month. And then you'll be doing this by publishing, making merchandise, making products, getting your stuff onto different pages, syndication, paying for Facebook ads, and start leveling up your investment. And then at the partner thing, when you really consider yourself ready to take on partners, I think it should be when it's the business is sustaining your own life, you're making about $4,000. How are you doing this? You're doing a lot of gigs, you have clients, and you're a legally established business at this point. You're making cash money. So the second part of speed that I got down is this gets a little bit more into the social media and then the engaging part, right? At the very basic level, entrepreneurs should be doing lots of social tagging, should be commenting on a crap ton of people's posts who are in your field, especially if they live around you, commenting, oh, that was really cool, I love what you did there, that was dope. You can see yourself, you're building a relationship, it's super easy, it's free, we're on there anyway, but usually we're commenting on the Braves crops or something like that. We use that time to comment on stuff that's part of our self-actualized self, and then we can volunteer. I think you have, on that level, how does that handle your experience?
It's really huge. So I try to attend at least 2 events a week, and I try to support or repost, you know, someone's event. I'm learning to have a phone charge when I go to an event, so I can post something really quick, make a video, make a comment, make it my style. I try to make things my style work with me. It's strange, but it's very true. We kind of look out for it, like,
And then volunteering, and then you actually—that's a huge thing to get involved
in. Absolutely. You know, I feel like, I don't think that we can live in the society that we have without problems. Why would we be preaching? But I'm just doing it because I look outside. There's a bunch of mess going on, and I gotta take an hour and week to be in this part of solution.
It helps you match your entrepreneurship to who you are as a human being, which is more than just that, it's caring. It's such a basic way of getting involved, and it might help your product. Maybe you would have sold more of the fluffy pig allergy, so fluffy pig allergy is just to continue with that metaphor, but maybe you would have sold more of it if you had started volunteering at some things and gotten involved in some sort of breast cancer thing, and then it would have just clicked. And you would have gotten, so it's a good thing to know your community, because we're not making products or business for ourselves.
That the magic happens outside of your house. So I like to say that you're outside of your house and you have these conversations that are so dynamic, it's so amazing. It allows you to create content as you share with your media, it comes to your side, to see you outside, gives you validity, and then it allows you to be present with the world, interacting with the world, and allows your products to interact.
And it's very true. And just to continue with what we did in the first one, so then you consider you're a creator when you're getting 50 engagements a week, and how would you be getting this? Through your audience, which you should know on Facebook, your blog, whatever, that's your audience. Your collaborators will be starting to engage with the stuff that you're teaming up with. They're going to look at your stuff. And then you have members, which is engaged people, like customers, people who regularly engage with your product in different ways. And so that'll start building up your 50 engagements a week, and now I think you're ready to start seeking that 270 engagements a week through feed featured at other people's events, utilizing influencers, letting them get on your products and stuff like that, which is just different people. All these words are just different words for people that you're engaging with.